afternoon, I am out here next to my house picking some grapes. And I'm going to be canning these grapes to make grape juice. Now, this grape trellis behind me, it's not a very good design. And it was actually put in before I bought the house. So over the next year or so, I'm planning on completely removing the grapes from this area and moving them over to where my garden is. So this has just been kind of a temporary structure over the last few years while I worked on remodeling the house. Alright, so I ended up with two colanders full of grapes. So I've got that one and this one. Now I just need to go through and clean up the grapes, because there's some bad ones in there. There's some that are underripe. Picking them, it's always a matter of waiting for more of them to be ripe, but that means more of them turn bad. It's always kind of a fine balance when it comes to picking grapes. So what I'm going to do is set up here and just start picking out the good grapes and moving them over to a colander here where I can clean them up and get them ready to go into jars. Now that I have the grapes clean, the next thing to do is add 1 cup of grapes per quart. And now to each jar, I add 1/4 cup of sugar. And this you can kind of adjust to taste, so you could probably go as high as maybe 1/3 cup before it kind of got to be too much. So the next step is to simply top off the jars with water. And I'm going to go right up to the neck of the jar, and that'll leave, you know, a little bit of headspace there. And I've seen different recipes for this, and sometimes it says to use hot water, but what I'm going to be doing is starting off from a cool canner and then bringing it up to a boil. So by doing that, I can save myself dealing with boiling liquids and just use some cool water here. Alright, so now I've got my lids hot and I've got the canner warming up. Now it's just a matter of putting the lids on, popping them into the canner. Magnetic lid lifter like this works wonders. You don't have to go in and fish them out. Alright, got them in the canner, they're starting to warm up. Something you always want to make sure is that once you place your jars in the canner, that you can kind of give them a little wobble and they won't bang into each other. Once they start boiling, they really start vibrating. Now, when it comes to canning these, there's different recipes. Some of them call for hot water bath processing. Personally, I like to pressure can them just to be on the safe side. Now the pressure canner that I use, it's one of the super simple jiggler type pressure canners.
So it has this little weight that goes on the top, and the way you set the pressure is by adding or removing these little rings from the top of it. So by itself, this top is 5 pounds pressure. Then adding the next ring makes it 10 pounds. And then the next ring on that makes it 20 or 15 pounds. Yeah, 15. For the grapes, I'm going to be processing them at 5 pounds for 10 minutes. So here we have the finished grape juice right out of the canner, and you can see that the color has gone from the grapes into the juice. Now whenever I get ready to drink this, all that I have to do is strain off the grapes, and I like to dilute mine a little bit just so it's not quite as sweet and as strong. But here you can see this is the next batch that's going in, what it looks like before. So yeah, grape juices, super easy to can.